Hello my friends, welcome on this video, Daniel is here from Tips to Fix, and today, in this video tutorial, I'm going to show you something cool. Microsoft new native driver for NVMe Windows Server 2025 promises better performance on SSD drive. So now, advanced users of Windows 11, they test this registry tweaks on Windows 11 Home Edition and Pro Edition, and they saw some real improvement. Today I'm going to test these tweaks, guys, and show you how to do it, if this method will really improve your SSD drive performance. First of all, we are going to test the speed of my M2 drive before doing anything on the computer and see how fast it is. We will do the tweaks on registry keys and then we will test it again and see if we have any different on performance. So continue watching and let's test these tricks, guys. So let's go directly to the point. Let's see the post on Reddit. You will see this announcing native NVMe in Windows Server 2025, ushering in a new era of storage performance, 80% on EOPS. This is reading and writing and copying the data. Before it was 1.8, now 3.3 megabyte. If you see here, you can enable this now on the latest version of 25H2 Home or Pro Edition. I'm going to say you something, guys. Read this disclaimer here. This native NVMe driver support hasn't been officially announced by Microsoft for Pro and Home Editions, okay? So you have to know this before you do any changes on your computer. Thank you, I tested on a regular laptop and improvement was very slight, not that much. Double the write speed on Q32 is not a minimal. Super. Now, let's see the Microsoft post. Windows Server news and best practice. I can't measure any improvement. In fact, I only get worse number after change. I'm curious, guys. I'm going to test. Let's test it together. That's the point. This is the reason why I'm doing this video today. You see these commands here? These are for Registry Editor. I already have it here. First of all, what I'm going to do, I'm going to download CrystalDisk. Go ahead. CrystalDisk version, this version here, CrystalDiskMark, this one, installer, just download, 5 seconds. Okay, I'm going to install. Now we'll launch CrystalDisk. My local C drive is almost full and is 92% full. This is very important that you need to know, but I'm going to explain you later what to do. Now, I'm going to do the test with 1 gigabit file. And profile, it will be default, and read and write, it will be as it is. Now, let me explain you just a little bit what's very important. Look at this, guys, this parameter, RND4K, this parameter here, Q32T1, is how well the SSD can handle many small requests queued at the same time. So, if you do a lot of requests in the same time, you open up new tabs, new programs, new softwares, how well the SSD can handle many small requests. And if this number is big, it's very good for your SSD. So that's the point. You will see the difference with the tweaks that we are going to do today on both of these, Q32 and Q1T1. Okay, so this is very important for server, but also for us on Windows 11 Pro and Home Edition. I want my Windows 11 faster. This one here, this parameter is how fast an SSD can handle a single small request at the time. This reflects the real-world responsiveness, such as opening apps, booting the system, and general system performance. Let's do this test before doing the trick and after doing the trick. I'm choosing C drive, huh? Click all here. Now test is started. So now let me explain a little bit what you see here. Reading is 3.2 gigabyte in my case. And look at this, writing is 170. This is showing the throw point of high speed of my NVMe drive, okay? The second one, this is speed for large file speed on single request. The third one is the one that I told you. Now I'm going to do this tweak and then restart the computer and test this again to see if this method will work great, okay? Open up PowerShell. Here it is, PowerShell, right-click, run as administrator. If you wanted to do it like I'm doing one by one, just copy the first line, bring it here, click enter. This operation completes successfully. Copy the second one, bring it here, click enter, successfully. copy the third one, paste. Now we did this. I'm going to check now in my registry editor if we add these lines. Regedit. Local machine system, current control set, policies. Okay. And now we have these three words. Let's see. 185. Here it is. 156. 156. Here it is. 735. 735. Now this is one method how to add these lines. Now, if I remove this now, delete. Okay, and use another method. I'm going to use another method to add. I will create new file here. Open up. I will bring this script, this code. We'll bring it here. I'm going to save as it is. And I'm going to name this file now. Enable, with this code, enable NVMe Windows 11 registry key. We'll click yes. Now, if I double click here and click yes, you sure you wanted to continue? Okay. Okay, now let's see here. Let's go back on registry. Look at this, three keys are back here. Now I'm going to create a new script. You will download this script, guys, on my website. I'm going to create a new script to remove these keys if you don't want it, okay? Remove what you add before. I'm going to save. Okay. I'm going to name this disable NVMe Windows 11. Speed up, you know, like I will leave it as it is here. And if you click to disable, click yes. Yes. Okay. Now, if you go back here, these registry keys are removed. Let's do it again. Enable. These are the numbers that we did. We just put this word 111 for each of one. Okay. Value data 1. Guys, I wanted to show you something. This is very important. For the moment, you will see here on the disk drives that I have here all the drives. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You see this HP SSD AX900 Plus 1TB. This is the NVMe drive that I already have here. If you double click on the disk, you will see here volumes, drivers, and details. You will see only this drive on the description. That's it. No description at all. Now let me show you in the moment when we do the trick, and in Registry Editor now we have the three keys. We are going to restart the computer, and the moment when we restart the computer, you will see that this drive here, all NVMe will remove from this area, from disk drives, and you will see it here on storage controllers or something. Remember my parameters here. Super. Now we are going to restart the computer and let's see. Just watch here now. Go to Device Manager again. And if you see here on Device Manager, in Device Manager now, you see only 1, 2, 3, 4 disks here. But where are the others? Go ahead, go down there here. Wait a second. You see this one here? This is new thing that it wasn't before. Storage disks. And we have here my NVMe drives. This drive here, HP, now have drivers installed by Microsoft, and this is well organized now. If you see here details, you will see NVMe disk. Okay, this is very important. Before, this was unknown from the Windows. Now it's known. This is exactly what this registry key, registry tweak that we did today, is doing. Okay, and you see it works also not only on Windows Server, but on Windows 11 Home and Pro Edition. Now let's test the speed, guys. Okay, friends, after we restart the computer, let's go and test again with CrystalDisk. And with this software, we will test it again. Let's open up Regedit. All these tricks are here. Let's test again. Let's see profile default. We need to do read and write here again. And click this button now, all here, okay? So guys, as you see, we have a lot of improvement on overall speed of writing. Writing it is faster. If you see before, it was 170, so it was small. Now we have 840, it's more balanced if you see it carefully. This is for overall speed. Okay, now if you see this one for 4K, as I already explained to you before, now it's faster. You see, it's more parameters here, 150 more. Okay, doing this tweak for my SSD drive, in my case, it is faster. You will have these two registry keys on my blog post on my website, and you can download it. You can apply directly on your computer. You don't need to write anything on your PowerShell. So now let me show you another trick that I have for you. This is bonus, guys, if you wanted to make your SSD faster. You see this drive here with red? This is not good, okay? The C drive is almost full, guys. Don't forget that. You have to free some space on your C drive in order to make your SSD drive running faster. If you want me to prove it to you, let me do it right now. I have a folder here, videos to delete. Let me delete it all for you. So I released some space from C drive. I deleted some files. Now let's go and do the test again. Crystal Disk. Then you will see that the performance, it will be better. So you see, guys, we have completely different things when you free space your C drive. Better performance on your SSD drive or M2 drive. Look at these guys. So these are the best results that I can get in my NVMe drive. If you decided to try, go ahead, download the registry keys that I publish on my website, and let me know if in your case it really speed up your computer and these tricks works for you, okay? I need to know. Now, if you are not satisfied with Windows 11 25H2 and you wanted to move to Linux, I did another video tutorial. Go ahead, watch how to install Zorin OS. I did the full ultimate video for you. Go ahead, watch it. Now, if you are on unsupported processor, unsupported computers, and you don't know how to install Windows 11, and maybe you're thinking it's not possible, yes, it is possible. I covered this topic in another video tutorial. Okay, guys, don't forget to subscribe my channel, and God bless you. See you on the next video tutorial.